How's it going, YouTube? My name is Blake Yarbrough, and welcome back. With this being the first video of 2020, I thought I'd start my first video off with helping you guys make money. Yes, I'm gonna tell you the top 10 sneakers, at least so far, that will release this year that you can buy and resell and make some money. Before we get started, I did wanna mention I will be posting a few of my personal items again up for sale on my site, atllocals.com. The link will be in the description below if you guys are interested in purchasing these. Some of the items will include this OVO puffer jacket. This just released, sold out instantly. Also be selling a few pairs of shoes. Like this one right here, my Nike Bayou Air Max 90, as well as the Air Force One. So click the link in the description below if you're interested in seeing what's for sale. Now let's get back to the video. Now, of course, this list will need to be updated as the year progresses because there is a whole list of shoes that we don't know are releasing yet, but I've went ahead and comprised a list of about 10 or 11 shoes that are guaranteed to make money. Now this list is in no particular order. I'm starting off with shoes that have been confirmed to release, and then I'll give you some that don't have a confirmed release date, but are definitely releasing sometime this year. So let's go ahead and jump into that list now. Starting off the list, we have the Clot Air Force One in the rose gold colorway. There have been multiple Clot Air Force One collaborations released now, and each one has went for well over the retail price. So while this shoe retails for $250, you can expect the resale market to be somewhere between $400 to $600, just depending on the size. Moving down the list, we have two more colorways of the Sakai LDV Waffles. And this is a shoe that I wish I had one of the original colorways, or even the black and gray pair. Wasn't able to get them for retail, and I'm only willing to pay retail for this shoe. But there's two new colorways coming, and that is like a white and bone colorway, and then also a totally blacked out pair. Personally, I think these colorways are a bit repetitive because they're very similar to the ones that previously released. However, this shoe still carries a good bit of hype, and with a retail price of $160, I expect resale to be somewhere between $350 to $500, just depending on the size. Next up on my list is a pair of Yeezys, and that is the Yeezy Tailgate Reflective. It looks like Yeezy and Adidas will continue releasing two pairs of each colorway. You've got the non-reflective and then the reflective pairs. And of course, the reflective pair is going to be much more limited, which drives up the demand. And of course, the resale prices follow. Now, I don't think this will be like the original reflective pairs that sold for anywhere from $600 to $1,000. I think this will be more like the latter pairs, where the resale is somewhere between $350 to $500. I think that's what you can expect on this Yeezy Tailgate Reflective pair. But it's still a good flip because retail price is $220, so it's an easy way to double your money. The fifth shoe on the list is going to be the Travis Scott Nike Air Max 270 React. This shoe is not going to generate nearly the hype that the previous Travis Scott collaborations have generated. However, it's still a Travis Scott collaboration. And for that reason, it's on my list. This shoe is going to resell, and the prices will basically be dictated by how limited the shoe is. I expect the resale prices to be somewhere between $300 to $450. However, if the shoe ends up being very limited, the prices will be much higher, strictly due to the supply. The next shoe on my list is the Air Max 90 Bacon. This shoe previously released many years ago, and Nike is bringing it back for Air Max Day, which will be at the end of March. There's still not a whole lot of information about this shoe. Is it gonna be a re-release of the original, or is it going to be a 2.0 with minor changes? That will drastically affect the resale prices. If it's a 2.0 version, basically if it's been updated and changed or modified in any way, the resale prices will be much lower than if it's a re-release of the original. Retail price should be under $200, probably around the $150 to $160 range. And I expect the resale price to be between $400 to $600, just depending on the model that we get. And that could drastically change once we get more information on this release. Next up on the list, we have two colorways of the Yeezy 380. The first colorway, the Alien Yeezy 380, was very popular and it's gotten really good reviews from most people that have them. However, it was a pretty limited release. I think the upcoming Mist and Blackout colorways will definitely be popular. And I think the resale prices on these will also be between $350 to $450. As you know, usually the original colorway always goes for the most amount of money. It doesn't really matter what brand we're talking about. Original colorways are usually worth the most amount of money. However, I think because of the popularity of this new Yeezy silhouette, I think this mist and also the blackout or total black colorway will do very well as well. As we get closer to the bottom of the list, this is a shoe that has been getting tons of attention on social media, is the Travis Scott Nike SB Dunk Low. After originally wearing it in the Jack Boys music video, Travis has been seen wearing this shoe to an NBA game as well. And just like the previous Travis collaborations with Nike, the materials chosen for this shoe are definitely wild and just don't really seem to match up, but it works. I don't know if it's heat or if it's hype, but they kind of look like they could have been made at a Hobby Lobby clearance section. Drop a comment in the comment section below. Let me know if you're looking forward to this Dunk Low from Travis Scott and Nike. Next up on my list is another pair of Yeezys. This is the 700 V3 in the all black colorway. This is another shoe that does not have a confirmed release date, but after seeing the popularity of the first release, the Azale colorway, I can guarantee that this all black colorway is going to do just as well as that one, or very, very close. All black Yeezys generally do very well, and the 700 V3 has gotten a lot of good reviews. And for that reason, I think this shoe will resell in the $400 to $550 price range. And that's my list, guys. That is 10 shoes that I think are worth reselling in 2020. This is part one. And I know what you're thinking. Wait. Where is the Off-White Jordan 5? Of course, that is on everybody's list. It will be an easy flip. I chose not to put it on my list because it's fairly obvious that every single Off-White shoe resells for a good amount of money, especially when it's a Jordan collaboration. And guys, there are more than 10 shoes that will be able to be flipped in 2020. This is just a personal list that I came up with to share with you guys to help inform you if you are trying to flip some shoes this year. All 10 of the shoes I listed will definitely resell for over the retail prices. And while I'm personally not the biggest fan of reselling shoes because I'm one of the people that is trying to get them to keep, I do understand that it is a great way to make money, and you can't really fault anybody for trying to make a quick buck. But that is my list. I'm sure there's plenty of others out there. Go ahead and comment down below. Let me know what shoes you're looking to cop in 2020, or maybe tell me a shoe that you want to flip in 2020. Either way, leave a comment in the comment section below, smash that like button, and I will see you guys next Monday.